Okay, hi and welcome to another vlog. In today's vlog, I'm going to discuss a few things, mainly why I've not been vlogging recently and some other bits and pieces. So today's vlog, I'm going to call it procrastination. That means basically, if you don't know what that word means, it basically means you're sitting around and you're just wasting time rather than actually getting out and doing things. So that's what I've been doing recently, and that's why I've not really been doing my vlogs. Now, I found myself being a lot more productive when I was doing my daily vlogs, even though I had a lot less spare time because of the vlogs. But as a result, I ended up being more productive with what time I had left. Because I now have a bit of spare time, I'm now wasting the spare time. That can be seen on my days off. So the way I work my shift patterns at work, and I've mentioned this before, I work a few days and I've got a few days off. So normally it'll end up working, I'll work 5 days in a row. After working 5 days in a row, I'll end up having a 5 days off period. And in them 5 days, what kind of productive things am I doing? Well, I've just had 5 days off. I've been back at work for 2 days, and has anyone seen any of my vlogs? No, I've not put any vlogs out on my 5 days off, and to be honest, I've got no excuse for it. Every day I think to myself, I want to get a vlog done, and I've got loads of content running around my head, and to be honest, I've got that much, not that much, but I've got that many things that I wanted to mention that I end up not mentioning any of it at all. So anyway, first things, I have finally got my cycling shoes. Wait there 1 second, I'll go and get them. So I finally got my cycling shoes. Woo! I've put them on and I've put the pedals onto the bike. I've not ridden it yet. Mainly because the weather's been brilliant in the UK recently. For those who don't know or have never seen a cycling shoe before, you've got these little clip-in things. You can just see it here. So you can see there's these little clips at the bottom here, and you hook the toe in, and then this back bit then lock down. And in order to get your feet back out again, when you've got your feet inside the pedal, you twist your foot outwards, and then it pops the clip back out, and then your shoe foot comes off. I've never ridden with these shoes before, or this style of shoe before, where they're clipped in. I must admit I am a bit nervous, and I've said this before. The main reason is, when my feet are clipped into the bike, and if you don't remember to twist your foot out, when you come to stop, your foot is still attached to the bike and you end up going over. I plan on doing this, or I plan on practicing when it's nice and dry. Now, I've done it at home. Gina, after I put the pedals on the bike, Gina was standing there and she was holding the front of the bike for me. And I was on the bike and I was trying to unclip my foot and clipping it back in again. However, it's one thing doing it whilst you're stationary, it's another thing doing it whilst you're actually moving along or you're about to come to a stop. So I'm waiting for a nice dry day. Not far from my house, there is a nice cycle path that's pretty much as straight and flat as you like it. It's got really nice tarmac on it. It's one of them really good cycle paths. Now I plan on cycling up and down the length of that because at either end of it, there's a nice tall lamppost. So I can cycle up to one end. When I get to the other end, before I get to stop, I can practice taking my foot out. If I don't, I've got the lamppost to grab hold of, cycle back down the path. And I'm planning on doing that probably 20 or 30 times until I get a bit more comfortable trying to take my feet out. I don't want to go out on the road in case I get to a set of traffic lights. One, in case I make a fool of myself, which I probably will. But more the fact that I don't want to have my feet stuck in and then end up falling in front of a car. So these are the Northwave shoes, and these have these little adjuster on it. So what you do is you turn this, and then it pulls the laces tight. If you need to get your feet out, just pull that lever up. Pull a silver lever up and then your shoelaces come out and then you can get your foot out of the shoe. What other things can I mention? Well, hang on, wait, hold that thought. There's somebody at the door. Ooh, it's come. Finally, it's come. Right, so, I don't know if anybody really knows, but up on my wall, I have lots of these pop collectible things. Let me show you a selection. Right. So I've been collecting these little pop things for a while now. This was my very first one that Gina bought for me. This is a Pac-Man one. I've got a Pac-Man arcade machine, which I'm going to do a vlog about separately another day. Now, these pops, if you've never seen them before, they're like little plastic models, or sorry, vinyl models, I call them. And you can actually get different ones within the range, as you can see on the back of the box there. So in this box I've got here right now is a set that I've just had delivered from Australia. Bear with me. So, for my birthday, Gina bought me these two. There's a Dr. Robotnik and a Sonic. As you can see on the back of the box there is quite a few within the range as well for that. But within this box, I have got the ones that I need to complete my set. Now, For example, there is one on the back of here, which is Yellow Sonic. You cannot buy it in the UK because it's only manufactured for certain people, which is really good because then it makes it impossible trying to get hold of things. So anyway, so with that, I found out that there's a Yellow Sonic that you cannot get in this country. And there's also a glow-in-the-dark Sonic, which you can't get in this country either. So within this box, I have them. Right, so I'm going to go ahead and open it. I'm not quite like Peter McKinnon. I like coffee, but mine comes out of a jar, like most people. Now, I am trying to be careful here, because I don't want to cut any boxes that are inside. Because for me personally, I don't take my pops out of their boxes. So I leave them inside their box. I bet some people do actually take them out, look at them and then put them back away, but I don't take them out at all. Right. First things first. This is the Sonic that Gina bought me for my birthday, and this is the exact same Sonic. They are both the same number, however this one, as you can see on the front of that box, says that it glows in the dark. This one doesn't. So that's one of the limited edition ones from over in Australia. And then this one is also the other limited edition one, which is the Yellow Sonic or Super Sonic. So this Yellow Sonic was a real hedgehog. You could actually get in the game of Sonic the Hedgehog 2. If you collected all your emeralds, and then after collecting all your emeralds and you proceeded through the rest of the game, if you're fortunate enough to get your emeralds well before the end of the game, you could then collect 50 rings, and when you double jumped into the air, it would then turn into Super Sonic. Super Sonic was invincible and he could run flat out as fast as he could. So that's why I wanted to make sure I got this one, because it was kind of like a milestone to make sure when you got Yellow Sonic in the game, that's what you were rewarded with. So anyway. So as you can see, there is quite a few of them here. Anyway, right, so first off, that is where I got my pops from over in Australia. Now, considering these things have literally traveled halfway around the world, the boxes are in really good condition. So this now means that I have got a full set. So I've got my Dr. Robotnik. I have Sonic with a ring, Sonic with an emerald, Shadow with a chow, Shadow on his own, and then glow-in-the-dark Sonic. Now, not forgetting obviously the Super Sonic. So that now makes a complete set. However, if you look back at the box, there's only six showing on the back of the box. However, to actually make the full set, you need seven, because there's the glow in the dark one, which the other one, this one doesn't glow in the dark, whereas this one does. I'll tell you what, let's try and quickly do a clip of that now. Forgive me, this is the inside of my tumble dryer. I'm trying to find somewhere dark to record this. Right. As you can see there, the one on the left is the glow-in-the-dark Sonic. He is actually glowing. It's a bit hard to try and get it to show up on the camera because the GoPro doesn't have a very good sensitivity on it in the dark. So I've had these pops delivered. Really happy I've got them. But I was also going to mention as well, I got a massive mountain of Huel Granola. I'm going to do a separate video about this. I'm going to put it out in probably a couple of days' time once I've come off my shift. But basically what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be doing a giveaway for that. So any of my regular subscribers who are people that actually use Huel or consume Huel, who are interested in winning a box or a couple of boxes of the Huel Granola, make sure you come back in a few days' time where I'm going to be giving away three boxes of the Huel Granola for absolutely free. There'll be more details about that in the next video. So thanks very much for coming back and checking out another video. I will be doing another mini Huel update, but as I was kind of more centering this one around these pops today, and my cycling shoe, I was going to just keep it as that. I've nearly been 3 weeks now off nothing but Huel. Don't worry, I still am on my Huel. However, I've not been having it religiously every meal. I've been having normal meals at night. Now, I've still not been doing any exercise, although I really should be doing. Mainly because this whole, what I'm saying about today, about procrastination, I've just been finding any excuse, to be honest. I think it's myself finding any excuse not to go out running. So I need to get out, I need to start doing some exercise, especially as it's probably only like 44 or 43 days now until my half marathon, and I've not done any training for that yet. So really looking forward to doing that. So thanks very much for coming back and checking out another vlog. I really appreciate your time and coming to check these out. And I hope to see you all in the future for another video. Cheers, and thanks very much. Take care.